Welcome back to Hampden Park in Glasgow. Sun's still shining brightly, but not on Hearts right now, because they've been dragged into extra time here at Hampden by plucky, brave Gretna. John Robertson and Charlie Nicholas are both with me. 1-1 then after normal time. John, could you have imagined this? Have Hearts thrown this away?
Well, it's not thrown away, they're still in the moment, but for me, it was a one-minute spell there. Bednar's through, has a chance to make it 2-0, finish the game completely, misses. Gretna come right down the other end. David Graham, wonderful run, great tackle for Robbie Nielsen. You think that's a defining moment, that's won Hearts the Cup, but no, Gretna have come back, and if I'm being utterly honest, I think Hearts are lucky to get the extra time.
Charlie, did Gretna deserve that penalty? Was it a penalty? Soft one, though.
I thought it was soft. I didn't think so. I understand why it's given. I think John O'Neill is already going down before there's contact made. You can see he's already on the way down. So for me, it wasn't a penalty. The referee was very, very quick to give it. He was in a decent position, and he gave it. But I have to say, you know, they've had three or four chances, Gretna, to get right back in the game. Suddenly, they get a bit of fortune because, you know, the linesman put his flag up because goalkeeper Gordon's moved. I think it's harsh on the goalkeeper. The referee done the right thing, letting play go on.
We're about to go into extra time. The Gretna dream lives on. Let's rejoin David and Ian.
30 more minutes and then maybe penalties. The only Scottish Cup final that was previously decided by a penalty shootout was when Aberdeen beat Celtic 9-8 in 1990. Charlie Nicholas will bore us with stories about that, no doubt, later, if it goes that far. Gretna kick off extra time in the 2006 Scottish Cup final. The team from the borders refusing to lie down against a side who've booked a crack at the Champions League next season in Hearts. Presley, Nielsen, up towards Pospisil, and knocked out by Chris Innes, the captain of Gretna, who played in a League Cup final here for Kilmarnock, when he and they were destroyed by a Henrik Larsson hat-trick for Celtic in 2001. Robbie Nielsen's long throw towards Jankauskas. Pospisil hunting as well. Hooked away by O'Neill, only as far as Julian Brellier, who's got a free kick.
The first touch was clumsy, that's what allowed Graham to get to him. Stephen Presley getting himself forward into the box, as is Tal, so maybe a little bit far out for a shot on target, but ideal to throw something into the back post.
Rudy Skatzel. It's deflected. And deflected just wide corner.
I think Alan Main's getting across if it is on target. Took a big deflection though. What's Main? Yeah, he had it covered.
Hearts pressing at the start of extra time. Hartley's corner. Main got a fist on it, even though Pospisil was standing in his way. Initially, O'Neill. Brady lost out to Brellier. And he's trying to spark Hearts again. Mikalunas inviting, and Jankauskas.
It's just one of the few balls that Gretna haven't won. It just clears Derek Townsley, who gets himself to the front post and has won so many in that position. Just clears his head. I'm not convinced Jankauskas is expecting that to fall his way. Reacted quickly enough. Just couldn't get it on target.
Scored in the quarter-final, scored in the semi-final, but not in the final yet. Skelton. James Grady, who came on in the closing minutes of last year's final for Dundee United. Townsley. Grady onside. Here's Davy Graham. He's been held back there by Julian Brellier. Free kick, Gretna, edge of area.
Well, Well, time will tell whether this is the right decision here by Brelli. Clearly thought Graham had support. Determined not to allow him to set up a supporting midfield player. What a handy position to have a free kick in.
Well, Mark Birch hit one at this end during the 90. John O'Neill is there along with Birch. Birch has moved away. John O'Neill, though, can't bring it down in time.
It's a decent effort. They've got a lot of big lights in the wall. John O'Neill has to get the ball up really quickly here. He's never coming down for him.
Skelton. Townsley turning it back to Main. Tosh. He's been caught late by Brelier. Now he's going to get a yellow card. I've been given away the free kick on the edge of the area. Surely I might just let him away with it.
I'd be surprised if he does. Stevie Tosh wanted a lot of time on it, you have to say. It's more a question of Stevie Tosh's right foot as it follows through and makes the pass. That's when the contact takes place.
Money has let him off despite those two quick tackles. Birch launching it. Skelton, well, fancy footwork from him, but Mikalunas to the rescue for Hearts. Nicely done from him. Hartley. Gotta be careful, Birch. He's lost out to Pospisil, who sets it up for Rudy Skatzel. Off the post. Skatzel. Well, that's twice they've hit that post in this game, Hart.
Well, a leap of Mark Butts here. Just bullied out of this ball forward here by Pospisil. Ends up wrong side. He sees the run here of Skatzel, who's got time to take a touch and pull the trigger. Surprised he didn't put it back across Alan Main.
Corner though, Fisas near post, but McGuffey keeping him in check. Here's Brelliet. Hartley, he might have room to have a shot. He did, and it's a smart save from Alan Main.
Well, it certainly is. It dipped just in front of him. An important thing is he gets it wide here. He doesn't push it out because Jankowskis is following it in. Horrible dip, and a very decent save.
Hartley more than capable from range. He is the man who's going to take this corner. Hartley in and away by Chris Innes and then by John O'Neill. It's going to come to Brelliet. Mikalunas. Innes cleared it, but Mikalunas will try again. Alan Main claims it for Gretna.
Oh, he's done so well today, Alan Main. Normally the older goalkeepers get the less inclined they are to come for crosses. They normally stay and leave that to the boys in front of them. But Alan Main has come for everything this afternoon. It's been a misjudgment yet.
Davy Graham is going to have another run at Hearts. And now Grady. Can he get to it in time? He can. Kenny Duker.
He's under a little bit of pressure from Robbie Nielsen, but he should be hitting the target. He's actually maybe offside here, Duker, as the ball's played wide, but he's not in active play. And he wins it cleanly enough when it comes back in from Grady. Can't get it down.
Nielsen. Who is going to win the Scottish Cup? Gretna, the 350-1 outsiders of outsiders before the tournament began. Yet here they are on Cup final day, level with Hearts. Pospisil has set up Mikalunas though. he's got his cross all wrong.
That's a good ball. John O'Neill, it was caught with the ball inside him to get Mikkel Yunus down the outside. John O'Neill just watching the ball. And Mikkel Yunus had a lot of time to put in a better cross than that.
The managers can only watch and hope. Carlos Ivanauskas at heart. Ron Alexander, who has presided over Gretna's remarkable success story. Helped, of course, by Brooks Marson, who had a dream and decided to live it. Hartley, Tavisas, Fisas. It's Skatsel taking it first time. It was always going to be tricky.
I don't know whether he's trying to score or get it back across goal for Jankauskas, but again, he never really got a hold of it.
Oh, it's come off Ibrahim Tal and Grady. Let's just get a sniff, he does. Birch. Grady still over there. Davy Graham trying to latch onto it.
I think you probably see why Brayley was brought on there. Brayley matching the run of Graham.
Almost 10 minutes gone of extra time. That's a foul. On Mikkel Yunus. John O'Neill, and Gretna will be believing again. McGuffey's cross. Craig Gordon fouled by Kenny Duker.
It's a good take nevertheless. Under real pressure. I think Gretna will do that every set piece at all now. They'll throw Innes up, they'll throw Townsley up to join Duker.
One in an intriguing Scottish Cup final. The old firm nowhere to be seen for a change. Hearts and Gretna going for glory. Townsley. Didn't make it easy for Birch, but he coped. Fisas now for Pospisil. It's going to clear Jankauskas.
Nobody attacking the back post. Pospisil had a chance to get his head up as well.
Craig Gordon coming out to deal with that. Duka just getting back on his feet for Gretna.
Oh, he looks tired, really tired.
Gretna might be about to take off Kenny Duker, who has run himself into the ground. Here's Davy Graham, who is still running, beavering away for Gretna. William Kaskis might have a problem here as Gretna prepare to make that change. So, Dr. Goals unable to add to his tally today. The medicine man makes way. Kenny Duker, qualified doctor. He's been replaced here by Jamie McQuilkin. Duker has had another fantastic goal-filled season, but he is one tired man.
Does he meet the sandwich here, Jankauskas, between Townsley and Skelton? If he has tweaked a groin there, I'll be surprised if he continues.
Well, they have used all three subs, Hearts.
Struggling, look.
Kauskas will have a little option but to carry on. They could have done with him for this free kick. Skatsel takes it. Adam Main has grabbed a few of those. 38 years of age now, the Gretna keeper. He was 23 when he played in the cup final for Dundee United. Robbie Nilsson. Oh, he hasn't cleared it at all. Brady now. Brillier makes the challenge, but Brady gets up and Brillier bites back.
Good referee by Jimmy McDonald. Thought James Brady had a decent advantage there.
Advantage played here. Mikalunas. Can he come up with a precise pass? He's been taken out by Stevie Tosh, who is going to get a yellow card.
Yeah, I think he knew right away Stevie Tosh, he was looking at a yellow, wasn't within playing distance of the ball. Great feed by Mikalunas. Haas will look to him, should be fresher.
Tosh joins Mark Birch and Rudy Skatsel in the book. And Paul Hartley is sizing up this free kick. Long way out, but if anyone can, he can. He does have Stephen Presley to aim for if he prefers. Along with Jankauskas and Brazil. Hartley trying to find his range! Very nearly did.
Well, I wonder on that occasion whether Alan Main's getting across. The reaction of Hartley tells you how close it was. Main adjusting his feet very quickly, right arm up, full stretch.
This game of football really does throw up some remarkable stories. And the Gretna story is set to run and run. They are halfway through extra time, 15 more minutes, and if it's not decided then, we will have a penalty shootout. Gretna reached the final without playing a top-flight team, but now they've finally got to play one. They've coped pretty well as they've coped with most things this season, David.
Well, they certainly have. I thought after 10, 15 minutes they were going to be steamrolled by Hearts. The tempo that Hearts started with was what we expected. Chance after chance, but they passed them up. And I've got to say the change that Rowan Alexander made, I think has been central to the way this game is sitting at the moment. The introduction of Graham, they went 3-4-3, started to get out Hearts and haven't looked back since then.
Stephen Presley hoping that he will get to lift the Scottish Cup for Hearts soon. It's going to take a bit of work to reach that point. Robbie Nilsson, virtually a Stephen Presley look-alike. They like their beards at heart. Here we go then with the second period of extra time. 15 more minutes. If they aren't separated in those 15 minutes, we will have penalty kicks to decide who wins the Scottish Cup for only the second time in the history of the competition. Nilsson. Mikalunas. Fisas. Last week. Now they are keeping Hearts waiting for their holidays. Fisas getting ready with this throw. Aspazil now for Hartley. Nilsson, Brillier, Mascalunas. Taken by Skatzel. It's Jankauskas, but there's no room for him.
It's good defending. Derek Townsley, goal side of Jankauskas, just stayed in his feet there, determined not to dive in. A little reverse there by Skatzel to find Jankauskas.
Jankauskas looks like he isn't going to be able to continue, you know, and Hearts have used all three subs and stayed down with that injury reoccurring.
Yeah, if he's done his groin, he's clearly struggling. Maybe cramp. So Fallon Mains bending the foot to stretch the calf. Not a lot of contact in that.
Not very sporting of Alan Mayne. He's going to have to carry on. They have used all three of their subs. Cup finals today and coming on Wednesday. Sky Sports 1 from 6. The Champions League final from Paris. It's Barcelona against Arsenal. Vasquez moving gingerly with no option but to carry on. Across, but away by Tal. Tosh. I can't believe that, Stephen Tosh.
Well, it's half, his foot is high, but I don't think there's any contact here with Paul Hartley. Did well to win it. And he had to get his foot up early.
Kaskis returns, not 100%. Man down again. They're all dropping at the moment. Skelton quickly on his feet though.
This is a terrific game. Playing one in now on the left side with Jamie McCloken. Playing left midfield. One in beside John O'Neill now.
I think Skelton was voted Gretna's player of the year by his fellow players. Derek Townsley and Michael Pospisil contesting the drop ball. Don't see many of them these days. Stephen Presley. Offside Jankauskas. Maybe not Pospisil.
Well, he certainly feels he made a late run, he was on. Yeah, he's well on.
Well, he's making the point, Pospisil. Last 10 minutes of extra time, still 1-1 at Hampden. That's bounced off James Grady. This is Gretna's fourth season in the Scottish Cup. They were playing English non-league football, of course, not that long ago. In the previous three seasons, they never even got past the third round. Here they are in the final. Here they are, level with Hearts. Brellier and McGuffey became entangled. The end result is a throw-in for Hearts. Pospisil. Fisas. Pospisil. It's cleared by Mark Birch. High into the sky, Hartley underneath it. Then Townsley, Mikalunas. Townsley muscling Jankauskas. But here is Jankauskas. It's going to come to Fisas. And, oh, how about that? How about that for a calm header from Mick Wilkin? It's not easy to stay cool at this stage of the Scottish Cup final. The cup is up for grabs. McCorkin. Nilsson should cut that out. Grady giving him a hard time though, that's typical of Grady. And McCorkin now. Here's Skelton, who's been superb. Here's Ryan McGuffey, who scored the equaliser. Tosh. Nilsson kept composed and it bubbled in front of Craig Gordon.
It's not the first one we've seen this afternoon. Took a big bubble just as Craig Gordon was going to strike it.
Here's Davy Graham and Tal able to hook it away. And that's a foul by Pospisil on Birch.
I think this might be going back post.
Tosh actually went towards John O'Neill, who wasn't the intended target. They were trying to pick out the centre-halves. A waste of a free kick. 7 minutes away from penalties. Hooked on by Scapsall. Snapped away by Alan Mayne. He's off his line here, and Mikalunas was under pressure. Mikalunas conceding a free kick. And Gretner in a hurry. Skelton. Here's Davy Graham, who is racing away again, not for the first time. And Craig Gordon cut it out, and the crook in this far post. Mikalunas, Nilsson, the tension mounts, good throw that, Pospisil, can he make it happen for Hearts? Nilsson centre was never going to go that far, and now Gretner, trying to start something.
Just struggling to get support there, Steve Tosh, a lot of tired legs out there now.
Fisas. Skatzel is onside. It's Rudy Skatzel. Held up by Alan Mayne. And it's a corner.
Well, I'm surprised Skatzel didn't go down. Had a chance to go down. There appeared to be contact as he goes round Alan Mayne. He was determined to stay up, to be fair to him.
Well, Fisas has got a yellow card for his protest.
Well, he's well onside as the ball is put through. And to be fair to Skatzel, he does everything he can to stay up. There is contact there. But in trying to stay up, he's made Dougie McDonald's mind up. He saved the referee a difficult decision. Certainly contact. Had he gone down, he would have got a penalty, I'm convinced of that.
The main man. Tapos thinks that's got a yellow card for his rage at the ref. Hart's still looking for that winner though. Hartley's corner. Mikalunas will retrieve it. There are 4 minutes left of extra time. Mikalunas across. And Alan Mayne is superb today, has grabbed it again.
Been terrific. I mean, again, he's under pressure. He knows Hart's looking for it. He's piling into the back post. Good, strong wrist again.
Nearly retired from the game a few years ago and in a bad injury. kept going. Shakira have got the free kick for handball, and Paul Hartley having another pop at Dougie MacDonald. The free kick's going to be hauled back, but Hartley fuming now. He's going to get a card. Losing their rag hearts. Minutes left. If somebody scores now, it would surely be enough to clinch that famous piece of silverware that is the Scottish Cup. Skelton floats it in. Innes can't get near it, and there's a free kick going Hart's way anyway.
I think it's given against Innes on Tal. He's done so well in either box today, Chris Innes. Arrives late there, Tal already on his way up. Barred by Innes.
Well, if it goes to penalties, it's anybody in that particular lottery who could win it or lose it. Only once before has the Scottish Cup final been decided on penalties, when Aberdeen beat Celtic 9-8 in 1990. Charlie Nicholas, one of the penalty takers that day. It looks like we might just have penalties here to separate Hearts and Gretna. What a plucky performance from Gretna. They've got a free kick. Brazil penalised.
Well, Chris Innes had a thing there, he was going to go up to the back post area, but change of the mind there. Most important thing is that they're not caught in the counter. I think either side would take penalties off you now. Oh, well, if you lose one now, it's gone.
One way or another, there's going to be quite a tip twist in the tail of the Scottish Cup season. We're in the last minute of extra time. Penalties looming, and they are looming large. McQuilkin launches it, though. Danny Graham. It's Ryan McGuffey to hit it. He might get a second chance. And it's a corner kick for Gretna.
It's a wonderful layoff from Graham. Takes all the pace off the ball. Says to McGuffey, go and help yourself. James Grady as well. It's a tired effort.
In the closing seconds of extra time, Gretna have a chance to win the Scottish Cup. Skelton takes the corner. It's away by Robbie Nilsson. There's going to be 1 minute added on. And Hearts might have a chance to win it themselves. It's typical that Hartley should be involved. Townsley getting back to hold him up. But Hart have got the throw, and Hartley has reacted here. And he's off. Paul Hartley, just ahead of the penalty shootout, has been sent off for that reaction.
Well, that's the weakness in Paul Hartley's game, his temperament. It has let him down in the past. Remember the kick he had at Ross Wallace off the ball, and he's let himself down here. He's fortunate it's so late in the game, but I'm sure he'd have been one of the penalty takers if it does go to penalties.
The second yellow card for Hartley, he's off, and yes, he would have been taking one of the penalties. Hearts could do with a winner here. Nilsson takes it, but Adam Main grabs hold of that. Hearts have lost one of their penalty takers, but hang on, they've got a bit of defending to do yet. It is over, and incredibly, the 2006 Scottish Cup final will be decided by a penalty shootout. Hearts have lost one of their takers. Hartley sent off.
Welcome back to Hampden Park. Well, is the impossible about to happen? Gretna are still in it. It's 1-1 after normal time, 1-1 after extra time. There's the Gretna manager, Rowan Alexander. Ivanauskas of Hearts is trying to G up his players. We are now going to a penalty shootout. The atmosphere absolutely electric. John Robertson and Charlie Nicholas are both with me here at Hampden Park. John, I mean, how disappointed must Hearts be right now after today's performance?
I think it's not been a good performance. The first 20 minutes they were magnificent, done well. But from then on, you know, it's been an even match until the last half an hour where Gretna have bossed it. Gretna have had all the...
And as you place it, Jim, the secret, I think, you can change your mind because good players can change in a split second. But you've got to be calm and controlled about your run-up to the penalty kick.
Charlie, how irresponsible was Paul Hartley getting himself sent off with penalty kicks looming, and he no doubt would have been one of the key Hearts penalty takers?
Well, it's foolish, but I have to say I have some sympathy because Townsley has a clear kick at him. His reaction is, I mean, Townsley doesn't get a yellow card, but Hartley does. I think because he agitated the referee with the yellow card only 5 minutes before it, the referee made that quick decision. But I had some sympathy for him.
Well, another stage is about to take place, another chapter in this incredible afternoon here at Hampden. It's penalty kicks. Let's rejoin David Provan and Ian Crocker. Ian, do you still have your voice left?
Just about, Jim. They can't beat a penalty shootout, especially with such a big prize at stake. Craig Gordon and Stephen Presley embracing. Alan Mayne has had a fantastic afternoon in Gretna's goal. And Stephen Presley is going to take the first penalty in the shootout.
Doesn't miss too many, Stephen Presley. Normally goes with inside of the foot. Normally high as well.
The drama begins. Stephen Presley, the captain, shows the way.
That's a terrific penalty. He closes his body at the last moment. He's actually hit the inside of the side netting. That's not savable.
James Grady is going to be first up for Gretna. Craig Gordon, Scotland's number one keeper. The little man against the big man. Grady, emphatic.
I think he must have got a great in as it left his foot. It's pretty high, isn't it? Well, it just sneaks in under the crossbar.
What a perfect start for both teams. Perfect penalties. Robbie Nielsen is next up, Hearts' longest serving player. It's agony for those involved down there. Oh, Robbie Nielsen picked his spot.
Well, Charlie's talking about composure, and that is terrific calmness here from young Robbie Nielsen. Again, it's the body shape that foxes Alan Mayne.
Mark Birch is next up for Gretna. I'm sure Craig Gordon looks a very big figure between the sticks. It's Birch, and it's 2-2 on penalties.
That's an identical penalty to that of Robbie Nielsen. A late change in the body shape. Went up as if he was going to open his body and knock it into the right-hand corner.
Well, Rudy Skeptel is next up for Hearts. He scored towards the end of the first half. Hearts probably thought they were on their way to Scottish Cup glory. They weren't. Here comes Skatzel. It's another excellent penalty.
Well, I've got to say, it's been a masterclass so far. Another lesson in composure here from Skatzel. But the pressure continues to rise now. And the boys are waiting to step up.
And Derek Townsley is next to endure the agony. Here he comes. Oh, Townsley's effort is saved by Craig Gordon. Advantage, Hearts.
Derek Townsley's face tells its own story. It's a poor penalty. It's not even a yard to Craig Gordon's left. Not a difficult save for him. Advantage, Hearts.
Hearts 3-2 up on penalties. Nobody has missed for them yet. Pospisil is next to have a go. Well, their penalties have been awesome.
It'll be interesting to find out whether they practice a penalty scene, because they really have been terrific. I know it's a different ball game on the day under pressure, but Hearts penalties have been different class so far.
4-2 to Hearts. It means that Gavin Skelton has got a score here. He's been terrific today. Yes or no? Skelton! No! Hearts have won the Scottish Cup! But what a plucky performance from Grittner, who took them all the way. An extraordinary season in this famous competition comes to an end with Hearts celebrating. Their fans proud to be a jumbo to the bottom of their hearts. But you have to feel for Grittner, who gave so, so much.
Yeah, they certainly did. Hearts certainly did it the hard way. I've got to say, the penalties from the Hearts lads were absolutely terrific. Under the most immense pressure, they came here under pressure, trying to put up with the burden of expectation on them as odds on favourites. If anything, there was even more pressure on the Hearts lads when it came to penalties. Boy, did they handle well.
Oh, Paul Hartley sent off in the closing stages of extra time, but a Scottish Cup winner all the same, and Valdis Ivanauskas has steered Hearts to the trophy. Craig Gordon made that save from Derek Townsley. Ivanauskas, the manager at the moment, but George Burley and Graham Riggs can certainly take a bow too. Hearts season has been one long, crazy old rollercoaster ride, and some people have been pushed over the side, but Vladimir Romanov is delivering. Whatever it takes, a place in the Champions League and the Scottish Cup. Grittner have a million memories to last a lifetime, but they fell short when it mattered in the lottery of the playoffs. Only just short. A truly magnificent effort from Grittner, and they will continue to live the dream. They will move into the First Division, and you wouldn't be surprised if pretty soon they'll be back playing the likes of Hearts in the Scottish Premier League.
Well, they've had a taste of it. They've had a look at what the second best team in the country can do, and they took all the big shots today and came back at them, kept coming back at them. May feel they were unlucky not to win the game in extra time, but they'll be back. This will give Brooks Myelson, who is the central figure in all of this, let's not forget, this will give them a taste for the big time, and I'm sure he'll want more.
Well, the two managers embrace. In a season of shocks in the Scottish Cup, there wasn't to be a final surprise. Grittner have a place in Europe, and they had to pinch themselves just to believe they were here in the Scottish Cup final. They were here all right. They took Hearts to extra time, to a penalty shootout, when really it was always going to be whoever felt lucky, whoever got lucky. Grittner living the dream, but Hearts are living a dream of their own now. A Champions League place, and now a trophy. Gavin Skelton, who's been one of Grittner's most prominent players today, unable to score from the spot. And that handed the Scottish Cup to Hearts. They did it the hard way, but then after the season they've had, well, perhaps it's no surprise that they did it in such a way.
Yeah, I certainly wouldn't blame Gavin Skelton. I wouldn't blame him for putting his foot through the ball. We saw so many penalties tucked away with so much composure, but the more that pressure was turned up, the more likely I think Skelton was to run up and hit it with everything he had.
Brooks Myelson, who has made it all possible for Grittner, along with Rowan Alexander, hugging his players and every single one of them gave their all today, and there's every reason to feel proud of their performance. Derek Townsley distraught after his penalty was saved by Craig Gordon. Nearly but not quite, but this is most definitely not the last we have heard of Gretna. They have plucked themselves well and truly on the football map. But as always on Cup Final Day, the day belongs to the winners. And the winners are Hearts, who've had quite a season themselves. A season that began with George Burley as their manager, that began in spectacular style as they won game after game after game in the league. And then Burley departed. Graham Riggs later left too. Turbulent times, but through it all, the Hearts players kept themselves focused on the job. They'll have a crack at the Champions League next season, and they will take the Scottish Cup back to Edinburgh. Gretna's consolation is the fact that they've done themselves so proud today, and also they will get a crack at the UEFA Cup. Poor old Alan Main, a cup final loser 15 years ago with Dundee United. Pulsating performance from the keeper today, but you have to say Hart's penalties were simply fantastic.
Got them off the hook, Ian. I think it's fair to say that the penalties got them off the hook. It was a poor performance over the piece from Hearts. They were matched, but for the first 15 minutes, I'd say they were matched for the rest of the game. But by Gretna's side, too, I think as the game wore on, realised they had nothing to fear.
Well, there'll be a big party down the Gorgie Road in Edinburgh tonight. In fact, there is one chap holding a birthday party there. I think a few others will be inviting themselves. Let's hear from the Hearts keeper. Scotland's number one, Craig Gordon, is with David Tanner.
Craig, many congratulations. Sum up your emotions at this time.
Oh, it's fantastic. Mostly relief, because I think everybody expected us to come here and win very comfortably. I got the credit in the world to Gretna. I thought they were fantastic. The game plan to frustrate us and slow the game down. They not only did that, but they created loads of opportunities themselves. So I think we can find ourselves very fortunate to go up to lift that cup in a wee minute.
Were the players nervous today?
It looked that way. It looked as if we had a long, hard season. The last few weeks have been very tough trying to get in the Champions League. I think that showed in the legs out there.
Had you all practiced penalties?
No, we didn't. I thought the boys that went up there, very cool, slotted them away, absolutely magnificent.
Craig, as a Hearts fan, I know you'll enjoy your night. Well done.
Cheers, thank you.
Well, these Gretna players have been superb all season and perhaps deserve more out of this very special day. A wry smile from Alan Main. They gave it their best, and their best was brilliant. And Brooks Marlson waiting to see every single one of them as they make their way down with their losers' medals. And soon it will be Hearts' turn, but they know they've been a bit fortunate today, David.
I think Craig Gordon summed it up there. He said this is a feeling of relief more than joy. And I think they know they've managed to get off the hook today, and another day it could have gone to Rowan Alexander. I've got to say, it's taken the defeat so well. Going round all the Hearts boys, shaking their hand, warm embrace with Valdis Ivanauskas as well. And both he and his team today have done this cup final proud.
Well, Gretna have captured the hearts of the football world, but Hearts have captured the cup. And Stephen Presley will be the man to lift the trophy. He joined Hearts just after they last won the Scottish Cup in 1998. He's been a terrific servant, and he deserves this moment. And you get the feeling he cannot wait.
And at the presentation of the winners' medals and this year's tenant Scottish Cup to Hearts.
Hearts make their way up. Stephen Presley will be last in the queue. Robbie Nielsen, the longest serving player. Craig Gordon has had a sensational season, firmly established himself now as Scotland's number one. winner's medals. Moments that don't come along that often in a footballer's life. Very special moments for the Jambos. And there is Stephen Presley waiting in line, waiting to get to grips with the Scottish Cup.
And now Jack McConnell, First Minister of Scotland, will present the Tennis Scottish Cup.
Gretna get the credit, Hearts get the cup. Memories are made of this. Hearts have won the Scottish Cup.
The Hearts did it, but my goodness, John Robertson, they did it the hard way, didn't they?
Well, we're edge of your seat stuff, and you've got a feel for Gretna, for Derek Townsley first, but a special mention myself for Gavin Skelly. I thought he was immense for Gretna today, absolutely magnificent. To miss that is heartbreaking for them, and, you know, history will tell you later on in life that Hearts have won the Cup today, but my God, they won it by the skin of their teeth.
Charlie, you rightly said, you know, having been in the position yourself, when you're walking up to take a penalty, you have to go up there with confidence. And poor old Townsley, and then Skelton. But in Townsley, you could see maybe he was having moments of self-doubt.
You could see fear. You know, defenders, you see Presley, for instance, going up, and it's pretty convincing. Hearts is penalties, but were first class, I have to say. They held the tension and the pressure. And that's the difference, Jim. When you're putting in the SPL and you're going for big prizes at the end of the season, you know, this is where you're paying the big bucks for. You're getting the boys are maybe on 10 times less salary per week, and they're having to find extra energy, extra mental strength. He got them then to do this torment of missing a penalty kick. I mean, in a way, it's sad for Townsley and Skelton because they both played excellent today. In fact, those two probably were, as well as Alan Main, men of the match.
Exactly, the best players amongst the Gretna boys. Will that moment haunt these two boys for a while? I mean,
yeah, well,
but surely shouldn't, John, because you know they've come here and they've as Charlie says, they've more than played.
You hope not. You know, you can go right through the match. You've had the chance that the young lad that come on, Graham's had. Chris Innes right to death. What a chance to win the cup for them. Then, you know, Scatchell gets brought down. There's moments pivotal. Ultimately, comes down to that. But I'll tell you what, if Gretna play like that in Europe, then Scotland will have a team proud to be represented in the UEFA Cup next season.
It says so much about a team's character, their pluckiness, and these Gretna fans today have been magnificent, outnumbered 3-1.
They've been the real stars. They've been singing, they've been bouncing, they've been jumping all day. The fact that Hearts fans were so quiet for so long tells its own story. The plaudits will go to Gretna, the cup goes back to Edinburgh. That's history.
I think Hearts fans everywhere around Hampden at the moment are breathing a huge sigh of relief, Charlie.
Yeah, normally I'm getting a bit of stick from them, but you know, they were very fortunate. Gretna had the best chances. I don't think this will ever happen again in my lifetime, in terms of somebody like Gretna making the cup final and taking it all the way, and really they should have won it.
What an afternoon we've had here at Hampden. This was the story of it. And John, when you look back, we will always remember how much Gretna played a part in this, but Hearts took this game by the scruff of the neck and they went right at them as we thought they would.
Yeah, we knew that the first 15, 20 minutes, Hearts notorious out the traps, and they did that. And there was chance after chance, Gretna survived. Then there was a terrific free kick from Skelton, I think it was, that suddenly lifted them. And from then on to the end of the first half, they were in it until Scatchell put Hearts ahead. But then you'll see now, chance after chance, Graham, what a tap. That's probably won the cup for Hearts, Robbie Nielsen there.
And we think Scatchell's away anyway, Charlie, judging by what he's got.
Well, he is still, he's still under contract at Hearts, and they thought they had signed him a couple of weeks ago. But we've seen that before. Petrov signed for Celtic in January and now wants away. If there's interest in England, which I'd be surprised if there's not, especially in George Burley at Southampton, I was a little bit, I had sympathy for Hartley here. I generally have to say, I understand why the referee has to give him another yellow card, but Townsley got away with it. And then when it comes to penalties, well, it's all about bottle, unfortunately. Someone has to lose.
Someone has to lose, and that someone was Gretna. But they will remember their day, John, no doubt about that.
I don't think they should just remember today. For Gretna, it's about the whole season. It's about winning the championship, it's about knocking out all the first division teams and taking second place Hearts to the very, very last kick of the day.
Well, amazing scenes as Hearts fans staying to a man. I have to say, though, behind us, the Gretna fans, most of them staying to, I think they're in a state of shock, most of them, because they can't believe that they came quite so close. Charlie, as so often happens in football, did Hearts...